What is up, guys? Bearmaul here, and I am here with episode 10 of Bearmaul Plays Minecraft. I am on my way back to the base from the mine because I actually just died. I pretty much lost everything but my shovel and my boots, which you can see there. Everything else went into the lava, which sucks, but I actually have a way to get that stuff back now. I talked about it a little bit last episode. But I built a blaze farm, and it is a pretty sweet blaze farm, if I do say so myself. I didn't do it on camera because it's not my design, and I don't want it to seem like I'm trying to take credit for other people's work, because I'm definitely not. Let me run, and I will show you. I don't know what it is about my nether portal that's really attractive to mobs, but there's just a huge pack of pigmen here right now, and I don't know why. They're in very large numbers. If anybody knows why that is, if you wouldn't mind telling me, I am super curious about what is going on there. Ta-da! There it is. Part of it anyway. This is just the top part. So I kind of combined Mumbo Jumbo and Ethos designs. Mumbo Jumbo had the elongated top part to help the blazes drop out of the spawn area faster, and I took that and I combined that. Oh, I planted a tree because I needed some wood. Ignore that. I combined that with Ethos. He's gonna shoot at me here in a second. I combined that with Ethos piston system to funnel them into the middle quicker, and it actually gets pretty decent rates. I built this little thing here so you could kind of see the farm as you come down. The problem with the elongated top part, as you can see, the spawner is not active. It's just sitting there dormant. And when you're actually standing down here in the area where they collect, it's not active. So I built a little waiting room, so to speak, right here. And see, now it's active. They're going to spawn in there. Let me just get a blaze or two to spawn and fall down, and I'll show you how it works. Alright, we've got a couple blazes in here real quick. I'll just show you how it works. This is where I'm keeping the blaze rods for now. So, this lever here controls that piston. This is all Mumbo Jumbo's design, so this shouldn't be anything new. So they drop down in here, and you can close that, and that just pushes a glass block, so if it does squish one, it doesn't do any damage, because it's a transparent block. And then this button pushes a stone brick into their heads, pretty much, and that should bring them all down to half of a heart. Now, on any normal day, I would have a sword, which means I could kill all these blazes in one swing, because as of 1.9, it does that swing attack. But I don't have a sword. I just want to do it the old-fashioned way and punch them all individually. Punch, punch, punch. Wonderful. Yeah. So, it's real slow without a sword. I don't know why I came here without one, actually. But that's the blaze farm. I've been spending a lot of time here off-camera. I actually burned through most of the diamonds that we had in our chests because I was enchanting a bunch of tools. Uh-oh. Yeah. Made a bunch of tools, bunch of armor. Some of it broke, some of it I lost in the lava, digging in the mine. That's why I was in the mine, just to get more diamonds, obviously, to replace the stuff that I lost. But I got a couple more things to show you back at home. I've been doing quite a bit of work off camera. I got some big changes to show you guys, I think. Alright, so back at home, like I said, I've had a pretty serious change of heart about the direction I want to go with this base. I don't think that I want to do this this big, serious, imposing dwarven thing anymore. It doesn't really feel very welcoming. I kind of feel like I'm in danger when I come through here, you know. So this first room, I like what I was trying to do, I think. This fire is really scary. I think I might put out the fire. I might like plant some flowers up there, and then yeah, like some different kinds of flowers. I might put some cats on this ledge when we get cats, so when you walk in you're like, ah, flowers and cats, it's real peaceful. And then for this main room, we were gonna do that huge great hall, you know. Huge change of heart there. Bit of backpedaling. Actually, I filled in the whole thing with dirt because I decided we're gonna have like this nice garden here instead of the big scary open room. So I got some flowers. We got this nice tall grass everywhere. Some animals. We got cows and chickens. There's some sheep running around in here. There was a horse. I don't know where he went. And it's just really nice. Just like a really nice. What is that sound? Oh no. Oh god, no. What is this? What happened? Who would do this? This is terrible. Guys. The garden is gone. The whole garden is gone. Oh. Well, I guess we're gonna have to go with the original idea. We're gonna have to keep the giant room. Well, that's a bummer, you know. I really liked the garden idea. I guess we'll have to stick with plan A, I guess. Sorry guys, I know you guys were really excited about the garden. Sorry that didn't work out. I don't know what happened. Apparently the floor was just rigged to explode, and yeah. I want to apologize for my terrible acting. You know, I tried. You gotta keep it funny sometimes. Do some funny stuff. But as you saw in the last shot, this main room is pretty well done. There's a zombie villager chilling in it. He likes it. I gotta repair the walls now, of course, because I blew them up. But this is the size of the main room. I did some stairs going down the sides here. Normally I'd get through this much faster, but the only tool I have left is my shovel. So I did some stairs here. I had to remove one to do the dirt floor. And I decided that having them out like this, having the stairs away from the wall, looked better than putting them in the wall. I tried it both ways. This turned out better. So everything is all polished. It's all the smooth stone. Oh, a few chickens survived. Or maybe just one chicken, I don't know. No chickens survived. So this room, designated by the smiley face, this is going to be my grand smeltery. And I've got a design kicking around for that in a creative world, which I might show you. Definitely a work in progress. Basically, the gist of the idea is it's going to have an input chest, an output chest, and a fuel chest. You obviously put fuel in the fuel chest, and it gets distributed among 64 furnaces. And then you also put in whatever you want to smelt, and that gets distributed among the 64 furnaces. And so basically, it'll smelt 64 of whatevers in the time it would take normally to just smelt one thing. And if I can figure out the logistics of it exactly, I might be able to even increase that to 128 furnaces, which would be ridiculous. But that'd also be pretty awesome. I think that's the goal. And I've had this design kicking around in my head and in creative worlds for a little bit. And my biggest setback is that this door is only 5 blocks wide. If it were 7 blocks wide, I could do 128, no problem. I'd have plenty of room to run the tracks up to the next level of furnaces. But with only 5 wide, I might have to settle for 64, or I might have to get real creative or real sloppy, depending on how you look at it. So things I still want to do in this room, fix the walls, obviously. But we're going to put in some big columns, I think 5x5 columns in each corner. And we'll just go around the staircase, kind of. And then I also want to put a 5x5 column in the middle of each wall. And then I want to do some kind of a big mural on this back wall. I was looking earlier, trying to find a picture of like an angry bear roaring or something. Because, you know, my name is Bearmaul, and I figured if we can keep it bear-related, that would be cool. But I'm having a lot of trouble finding either like a pixel art of a bear that's not like a teddy bear or a Care Bear or something, or finding a like a clip art of an angry bear that's simple enough to pixelate well. I didn't think that would be a problem at all, finding a picture of a bear like that, but it's turning out to be a bear. Literally. Well, no, not literally. Figuratively, it is a bear. Not a literal bear, that'd be terrible. So one of the things that I want to get done in this episode, and as a matter of fact, I will probably get done right now, is I want to beautify this outer area right now, because right now it's super messy. We have this whatever that is covering up the nether portal. We got the little horse stable type thing just sitting there. I will probably pull this ladder pillar off of the mob farm. This is only ever meant to be a temporary thing, obviously. So I'm not going to I'm probably not going to build any more layers on top of it, really. This little doohickey here that was meant to change the mob farm from drops mode into XP mode, meaning some of the mobs wouldn't die when they landed there. That doesn't work. It just straight up does not work. It works, but it's just super inefficient. We got this hole which goes down into a cave system, which I think I've mined it out. I think it's done. We'll just pretend that's not there. We'll fall into that at some point in the future. We've got this chicken farm out here, which I don't really want to move right now. We'll designate a place for that inside. But that looks bad out here, just sitting here, redstone exposed. All the sugar cane just chilling along the water here. I guess that's not awful, but that's not where it should go. And I just kind of feel, you know, when you, like, some people, I guess they're hoarders, but, like, you're driving through a neighborhood and all the houses look okay, and then there's, like, that one person who just has, like, piles and piles of junk in their lawn, like, 50 old cars, and they're all just, like, packed to the brim with just stuff, you know? Just, like, nothing important, just a bunch of stuff they don't want to get rid of. That's what I feel like our front yard looks like here. I'm probably just gonna, I'm gonna harvest all this wheat and probably just get rid of this farm. Honestly, we don't even eat wheat anymore because we have so much of this chicken from our chicken farm working overtime over there. The only thing I need wheat for is breeding animals, and I'm not really at a point where I'm doing that a lot. I have these cows, and I'm gonna need more cows because I'm gonna make lots of books in the future, but I think once I harvest all this wheat and combine it with the wheat that I've already got sitting in chests in the base, I think we're going to have plenty. I'm not worried about it. So I'm going to start to... You know what? I'm not going to start demolishing because I don't have a freaking pickaxe. I enchanted a bunch. Let's go see if I have anything decent sitting in the chest. Let's see. How many diamonds do we have right now? We have 12 diamonds. I had... Oh, no, wait. I got more than 12. Whoops. Not what I wanted to do at all. Ba-boom, 34. Okay. So I had almost 3 stacks, and I made a bunch of tools. Lots of them have broken and gone elsewhere. I've also just kind of given up on keeping this stuff organized, since I'm going to have to reorganize it downstairs anyway. So I'm just kind of, like, throwing stuff in a chest. This is a good digging pick. That's a fortune pick. Both are low on health. And these are just 2 unbreaking 3... picks. What's this? Efficiency 3, fortune 2. And this is just unbreaking 3. So these are only unbreaking. These are, all 4 of these are good picks, but about to die. Maybe I can repair something and it will cost me not a lot. Let's use 3 of these diamonds to make a new pick. Sticks are all the way down here. That's ladders. I don't want that. I can't wait till we get, like, a real crafting station set up. I've just been using this table in the middle of this room since I made this room, you know. Anvil is here. How much does that cost? 33. So I've repaired this pick in particular quite a bit. Let's grab those other 3 picks that were good. and see if any of them are going to be cheap repairs, like first time repairs. That one, nope, I repaired that one quite a bit. This one, yes, that will give us just a general digging pick. I'd rather have Fortune or Silk Touch. Yeah, let's do this. Fortune 3. I had a Fortune and a Silk Touch pick when I died in the lava in the mine. Super unfortunate. Lost 3 good picks. Alright, now that I have a pick, I'm gonna start tearing stuff down outside. And, maybe we'll put up a few little beautification type things. And before I forget to mention it, everybody meet our new horse. He is worse in every possible way than our previous horse, but he's faster than running. So I've been using him to transport myself back and forth from the mine. And hopefully he will not vanish like our last horse. I still don't know where that horse is. I haven't found him. He hasn't turned up. I searched everywhere pretty good. Looked all over for him, and he's just gone. There was one point where I lost the horse somewhere way over here, somewhere in these trees, but I could swear that I went and got him back. But maybe not. I don't know. That can be another thing that we do in this episode, is go horse hunting. See if we can't find another pack of good horses. There's still so much in this world that I haven't explored. You know, I've been so busy at home digging out that huge room and building a garden on top of it that I don't know where this goes. I don't know what's over here. There's a mushroom. No, not a mushroom biome, but the dark oak forest, the roofed forest, whatever they're calling that now. That's cool. We'll explore in a bit. One thing at a time, Bearmaul, one thing at a time. So that's a good bit better, I think. The farm is gone, I cleaned that up. It was open on the one side because of the way I had the XP farm set up, you needed access to the mobs. But since I pulled the XP farm part off, I also closed that up, so now it's just a solid tube. I think that looks a lot better. I had to keep this weird little room. This is where I AFK when I want to collect TNT or whatever. I need to empty that. And then for the little nether thing, I just built a little spruce wood face on it. Just to keep mobs from running into it. As you remember last episode or the episode before, or several times now, I think I've come into the nether and it's just been packed full of creepers right there. And they've killed me. So now I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to get my horse. And we are going to go do some exploring. I'm going to grab a couple leads, or make a couple leads if I don't have any. I think I have a few, though. Yes, I do. So hopefully we can pull some horses home if we find any more. Yeah, that didn't take long at all. I've been out running around for maybe 45 seconds, and I found 4 more horses. There might be more up the top of the hill, I think, actually. Yeah, there are. There's a bunch here. Okay. Cool. So maybe we should build some kind of a corral. Oh, wow, I hit the horse jackpot. Look at all of them. That is a lot of horses. I guess it's not necessarily a lot of horses, but it's definitely the most dense herd I've seen. Is that what it's called when it's a group of horses? Is that a herd of horses? It's not a flock. A flock is sheep. What is that? There's some bunnies. I think I'll come back this way and I'll grab the horses. I'm not ready to go home yet. I'm having a good time out here running around. There's a nice roofed forest. More horses. Wow. Yeah, I'm just going to keep exploring. I'm having a good time here. You know, one thing that I always forget to bring out with me when I go exploring is a bed. It's going to be nighttime before I get back if I turn back now. So I'm kind of having the debate in my head on if I want to burrow into a cave. I have some torches. I have food. I'll be okay for a night if I want to hang out here, or if I should try and head back now, and then maybe go off in a different direction. Ooh, a witch hut. All right, well, that pretty much made my decision for me. Oops, sorry, horse. He's only got what, 8 hearts? That's pretty bad. I'm gonna spend the night in the witch hut. Is that a witch in there? What is that? Oh, that's a flower pot. I haven't been following like the development of the patch notes. We're in 1.9.4 right now, and I honestly don't know what's different. I don't really pay attention anymore. I just play the game. So I need to stash my horse somewhere. I don't want him to run off. Let's see. My best bet is probably just to build another weird little stable type thing for him. Like this. Whoops. It's hard to build from horseback, isn't it? And they won't jump over too high unless you're on them and you make them jump that high, right? So he should be good in there for the night. And I want to get up here. And hopefully I'll be too close for any witches to actually spawn inside. Alright, it is morning. Well, it's almost noon now. I found my way back to these horses. I've got 11 leads, and there's about as many horses, so I'm going to pull as many of these guys home as I can. I expect to lose quite a few on the way home. Just because they'll lag behind, and they'll get too far away, or they'll get stuck in trees. That's 9 horses there. Yeah, see, I've already lost 3 of them. So we're going to have to go real slow, I think. Whoops, that's the wrong button. That's how we'll do it, maybe. We'll just walk them all home. Come on, guys. This is going to be a pain. Yeah, see, I'm just losing them like crazy. One popped off there, one popped off here. What I may end up doing... Yeah, actually, that's what I'm gonna do. I want to get my saddle off of this horse. And then I'm just gonna try and go around and tame each horse individually. Put the saddle on and just see how they do. Alright, I've only tamed a couple, but I think this brown one here, he's going to be the winner. He's pretty fast, and he seems like a pretty good jumper. Definitely the best out of all the horses I've tried. I'm going to park him over here, and I'm going to go get the armor off the other horse. And I'm probably just going to leave him out here. I'll come back. Obviously, I'm not a monster, but I just needed a better horse. This one's a lot faster, and really, I mean, I don't need a bunch of hearts. It's nice if they can jump, but it's not necessary for the most part. I really just want them for speed. There we go. Yeah, he's much faster than that white horse we were using. It's got more health, better jumper, pretty fast, so I'm happy with this one. Let's see if I can't find my way back home. It's been a fun little intermission going out and explore, but we should probably put in some more work on the base before we wrap it up here. Yeah, that mob spawner makes a really good landmark. I'm gonna have to figure out something else for when I eventually tear that thing down. We'll have some cool landmarks all over the place at some point in this world. There'll be a lot of stuff to build. I'm not really worried about it. Oh no! Wow. Okay. Uh-oh. I don't know how I'm gonna get out of here. Here's the way I got out when it was just me, not on a horse. I guess I'm gonna have to punch this out bigger so that it's horse-sized. A Okay, maybe I should mark that hole in the ground or cover it up or something so that doesn't happen again. Yeah, this horse is much faster than the last horse. Wow, that's a huge improvement, actually. So yeah, I want to fix what I broke in this room, patch up the walls, and then also I'll probably lay down foundations for columns, which I'll probably build off screen. I'm surprised he hasn't despawned. I went a good ways away. Oh, it's because he's holding flowers. So I decided not to go too crazy beautifying the outside, because I'm probably going to do some terraforming out here. I'm probably going to get rid of this little hump on the mountain there and get rid of this little lake where the cows are, where they are temporarily. Because I want to have like a cool path that comes out, and it kind of just goes into the cows right now. But I said we'd do some beautification, and I meant it, so I stole a flower pot from the witch hut. I'll put a flower in it. That's not where I want that to go. Can you not plant the two high flowers in a flower pot? Maybe not. Let's get a smaller flower. I thought you could. I'll just plant a poppy in it, I guess. What is going on here at the door? It's opening, closing. What is that? Oh, it's a leg. This is great. Oh, I had way too much fun with that. Okay. Flower pot and flower. That's much better. I like that a lot. What an amazing difference that made. Alright, I'm gonna get to work. I'm gonna fix these walls. This is another thing that I meant to mention. The bottom of the grand hall pipe thing isn't actually in a slime chunk. So I've got a decent amount of slime balls now, actually, from digging this thing out, because I kill them when I see them. So, we're gonna have to figure out some way to prevent them from spawning in the bottom, if we decide in the future that we don't like having slimes hopping around in the main hall. It's not really a huge problem for me, I guess. I don't mind if there's slimes in here. I guess it just depends on the overall aesthetic of this room that we end up with. It might be weird if there's if we have the big awesome hall and then there's slimes hopping around in the bottom. That just might be a little off-putting, maybe. We'll just have to wait and see how that goes. So this is what I'm thinking for those columns I mentioned earlier. One in each corner and then one in the middle. And so that's kind of where it peeks out from behind the stairs. When it gets up here, I want to have it stay the 5x5 profile that I'm doing. But I'm going to have to obviously like hollow it out here so that you can go through it. And I'll do the same thing here, which I kind of reflected in the footprint. So it'll be kind of like a little tunnel that goes through the column. So that you can still go up and down the stairs and stuff. I think that'll be pretty cool. We are getting low on time, guys. So I think I'm going to call it quits here, pretty much. Just real quick, though, I'll talk about what I think I want to do in the next episode. I imagine by the time I film the next episode, these columns will be done. I'm just going to go ahead and put them in there, because that won't take too long at all. Yeah. So these columns will be done, and then I want to finish up our little beautification project on the outside. So I want to, obviously we can't move the mob farm yet, we're still kind of dependent on that. Oh yeah, I locked the door so the horse wouldn't escape. So I can't move the mob farm, but I can move this nether portal. So we need to find a place to put it inside, and I'll show you what I'm thinking, actually. I don't want to move it too far away from where it is now, just because I don't want it to get messed up linking to other portals. There is another portal down there in the nether, which I explored briefly in a previous episode. So what I'm thinking is when you go down these stairs, instead of turning left or turning this direction to get into the main room, there'll be a door here. And obviously I'll mirror this on the other side. There'll be a door here that would lead to a bigger room. What's that? Oh, just airspace. I shouldn't have fell. I shouldn't have gone down in here. That was probably regrettable. So there'll be a door here. It might go down. It might stay the same level. I'm not sure, but that will be like our nether room. That's where the portal will be, and we'll decorate it all cool. I might do a really big portal. I don't know. We'll figure something out, and it'll be awesome. And then I might fix the ceiling off camera in between episodes. I'll get up there and I'll do a dirt ceiling, and I won't turn it into a garden this time. And I'll get that all polished up and looking good. And then another thing that I'd like to do, I don't know if we'll do this in particular next episode, but we need to do something with the front of the base. Right now you just kind of got the guts in there from where I patched it up. This is what the backside of the walls look like, basically. But I want to do some kind of a cool face that goes up, maybe about that high. So we'll have to design something and build that. See how that works. Just a couple ideas. We'll figure out some more stuff in the meantime that we can do next episode. But that's pretty much all I've got for right now. I hope you guys enjoyed watching the episode. As always, I enjoyed making it. Have a good rest of your day.